Amigos de La Pantera, amigos de La Clásica, muy buenos días. Continuamos con más, son las 11, perdón, 10 de la mañana con 33 minutos. Y bueno, continuamos con más de La Hora Social a través de estas emisoras. 940 en amplitud modulada y 95.1 en frecuencia modulada, La Pantera y La Clásica. Y bueno, Adrián, te voy a dejar a ti, tenemos a José Luis Zelaya desde el estado de Texas vía telefónica. Te voy a dejar que lo saludes, que salude también él a San Juana y ya que nos platique su historia. José Luis, muy buenas tardes en Texas, buenos días acá en Oregón, ¿cómo estamos?
Pues un gran saludo a José Luis, gracias por estar aquí en este programa tan importante, compartiendo un poquito pues de tu experiencia. Y pues aquí también estamos platicando de la importancia, ¿verdad? Es de ser un ejemplo y de compartir la experiencia para motivar a otros, para que no, ¿verdad? Para que sepan de las oportunidades que existen y muchas veces las oportunidades que nos tenemos que brindar nosotros.
José Luis, un dreamer, o como le llaman, o un soñador, del que queremos conocer su historia, del que queremos conocer sus vivencias a grandes pasos, para que la gente, la juventud, se vea en tu espejo, te tome como ejemplo y vea que sí se puede, que solamente está el decidirse precisamente a luchar. Te escuchamos atentos, José Luis.
Hello, my name is José Luis Zelaya and I am currently a 4.0 graduate student at Texas A&M University. But you see, my story was never a story of success. Actually, 12 years ago, I used to be homeless in the streets of Honduras, where I experienced a lot of pain and a lot of suffering, where I still remember at the age of 5 how I came home one day and I saw my mom crying because my younger brother had passed away. He passed away because we didn't have enough money to take him to the hospital. I experienced what it meant to be poor by seeing my brother pass away. And at the age of 7, I realized that I was the man of the house because my father, who was an alcoholic, used to abuse my mother. At the age of 7, I started cleaning windshields at a stoplight. I started cleaning, shining people's shoes at a park, and I started selling candies at a stadium because I was the man of the house. But you see, maybe I should have been in school. Maybe I should have been getting an education, yet I was working, being able to provide food for my mother, yet alcohol for my father. And at the age of 11 years old, I still remember how a Category 5 hurricane destroyed our house, where my entire family and I became homeless due to the fact that our house was destroyed by Hurricane Mitch. My father always beat up my mom. My father was always a very violent man who used to abuse my mother emotionally and physically. And it was then whenever my mom made the decision to run away from Honduras and to come to the United States to give my sister a better life and to be able to have the idea and the hope that one day she could be reunited with her son. Whenever she took the journey to come to the United States, I stayed behind in Honduras, where for about 2 years, I lived with almost without a father. And with the man who used to beat me up and used to abuse me. Yet he told me he loved me. Yet he told me that he cared about me. But his actions prove otherwise. At the age of 12 years old, I remember playing soccer at a stadium. And there was a drive-by between two very dangerous gangs. And at the age of 12 years old, as a little kid, I ended up being shot twice in both of my arms. I ran away and I seek for help. It was very tough. And just thinking about it and remembering gives me a lot of emotion. Because now I look at my life and I see that my life is a life and it's a story of success. But the reality is that in a lot of countries, a lot of students and a lot of kids are experiencing the life that I experienced 12 years ago. Whenever I was 13 years old, I made the decision to come to the United States to be able to look for my mom and to be able to come to this country, to be able to reunite with the woman and the little girl that told me that they care and that they love me. And I knew they did. So for about 45 days, I took a journey coming from Honduras to the United States by myself, trying to look for my mom, coming to the north without knowing where I was going, without knowing that I was breaking the law. All I wanted to do was to be able to survive. All I wanted to do was escape from a man that gave me freedom yet treated me like a slave. I wanted to be able to become free and to be able to be with the person that loved me. For about 45 days, I witnessed rape. I witnessed death. And I witnessed how people were left behind in the journey from Honduras to the United States. It is a very difficult journey that a lot of people don't make. It is a very difficult journey that a lot of people do not survive. But I was blessed, and with a miracle from God, I was able to reunite with my mother in the United States. When I came to the United States, I learned values such as integrity and loyalty and passion and inspiration, values that my teacher taught me. And that's the reason why I'm so grateful to the United States, which is the place that I call home, because it was an American teacher that inspired me. And it was a teacher that told me that I was college material. And even though I didn't understand what that meant, not only because of language barriers, but I was never told that I could become somebody. 9 years later, I'm a 4.0 graduate student at Texas A&M, pursuing a master's in education, because I want to do exactly what my teacher did with me. I want to go back into a classroom and tell my students that they are college material. I have been given so many job offers as a teacher, but because of my immigration status that I am undocumented, I am not able to teach. I am not able to go into a classroom and give my life to my students and motivate them and tell them that they are somebody, because I am told that I don't belong here and I am told that I'm a criminal. Yet all I want to be able to do is to be able to be a hero for my students. That is the reason why the DREAM Act is very important to me. And that's the reason why comprehensive immigration reform would give me the opportunity to be able to become a teacher. But it's not just about me. It's also about my mother. It's also about my sister and my neighbors and my community. That is the reason why we need comprehensive immigration reform, so that families are no longer separated and so that students like myself can have the opportunity to make their dreams become real. My name is Jose Luis Zelaya. I am an undocumented American, and I want to be legalized because I want to be a teacher. And that's the reason why so many people also want to have the opportunity to be legal in the United States, so that we can have the opportunity to give back to the home of the brave, give back to the land of the free, and to the country that we call home. We are Americans. We just happen to be undocumented Americans.
Mira, José Luis, simple y sencillamente nos quedamos. Nos sorprende tu historia, nos sorprende tu esfuerzo, tu dedicación, tu lucha por sobreponerte a todos los obstáculos que, como tú dices, desde niño se te presentaron en la vida. Y tal vez es todavía más destacado, más rimbombante, si puedo utilizar la palabra, porque lo hiciste siendo prácticamente un niño y sin documentación. O sea, llegas a estos Estados Unidos de brazos cruzados a decir: aquí estoy, pero voy a luchar porque sé lo que quiero. Esto lo digo con el propósito de instar a aquellos jóvenes que están ya en este país, que tienen una legalización, que tienen una documentación, y que por azares del destino, por lo que tú quieras, por una cosa u otra, mira, tú estuviste entre todas esas cosas malas de la vida, si podemos decir así, la drogadicción, el maltrato familiar, el alcohol, la pandilla, los pleitos en la calle, y sin embargo, siempre fuiste recto, siempre fuiste derecho, nunca te dejaste influenciar, nunca te llenaste de miel y anduviste entre la miel. Y hay jóvenes que tienen esa oportunidad de otra manera, con otras facilidades, y se desvían, José Luis. Tu ejemplo es magnífico.